In this video, I want to share with you how I color correct and grade my Mavic Pro footage in post using Final Cut Pro. I want to show you a very quick and simple workflow to transform your images from these to these. So if you saw my Mavic Pro camera setting video and you're using a flat color profile, you will know that the images straight out of the camera do need a little help. As a matter of fact, there's very little contrast and the colors are a little faded. So in this video, we are going to take care of this issue with a very easy and super fast workflow. I will try to keep this very short and straight to the point, so that even if you don't have a lot of experience with Final Cut Pro, you will be able to follow. Let's get started. All right, I've imported a few clips in my library and created a new project. Let's select the first clip and open the color board panel. There are a few ways to do this. The fastest for sure is to use the shortcut Command 6, and here we go. And as you can see in this panel, we can work on color, saturation, and exposure. My recommendation is to start from the exposure, as only after having a balanced exposure you will be able to understand which other adjustment your clip might need. So let's start working on the exposure. And to visualize and fix our exposure, let's open the video scope panel. Also in this case, there are multiple ways to do this. I use the shortcut Command 7. Here we go. On the top right corner, right here, we can select different views and channels. And for the exposure adjustment, let's select Waveform View and the Luma channel. Here we can visualize our exposure between the value of 0 and 100, where anything below 0 will be underexposed, anything above 100 will be clearly overexposed. So normally when using a flat profile in our Mavic camera, our exposure values are all here in the middle. And because our image has very little contrast, you shouldn't have any clipping in the shadows or the highlights. Our goal here is to expand our exposure, bringing down the shadows. And we will do this dragging down this black circle, barely touching the value of 0, and bringing up the highlights with the white circle going almost to the value of 100. The gray circle instead adjust the exposure of the mid-tones. And depending on our clip and the look that we are searching, we can lighten or darken the exposure. In this case, I will keep it right here. As you can see, this clip looks already quite different. Increasing the contrast, also the colors are more balanced and vivid. But I want to show you how the clip looked before this adjustment. And I can hide the video scope by clicking Command 7 again. And I can go back here, and by clicking the color correction, I will see my clip before the adjustment and after the adjustment. We can now go into the color adjustment. So Command 6 again, and I select the panel color. I can also decide to have a separate correction adjustment for the colors, and so I just click here on add correction, or I can continue on the same color board panel. If we set the white balance correctly on our Mavic, possibly we don't really need to do a lot of work on the colors. Unless we are trying to give a specific look to our footage, or we need to match the Mavic images with the images coming from another camera with a very different color profile. To check that our colors are balanced, let me reopen the video scope again, Command 7, and here I will select the channel RGB Parade. Here we are trying to give to these colors waveform and even shape. So basically, like in this case, you can see that the blue highlights are higher than the green and the red. So I will select the white circle and bring down the blues until they match the green and the red. At the same time, I can see that the red shadows are a little higher than the green and the blues. So I'll pick the black circle, go into the red area, and go down just a little bit. So as you can see right now, the three channels of the three colors, red, green, and blue, are pretty even and definitely more balanced in the image as well. Lastly, let's go to the saturation. And also, in this case, we can decide to have a separate correction for the saturation or continue on the same path. I want to see more pictures, so I will hide the Wavescope for now, Command Z. I can decide to change saturation with the global level on the left by dragging up or down, and the entire image, as you can see, will be modified. Or I can adjust the midtones, the highlights, and the shadows separately. And that's what I usually do. Most of the times, I increase a little bit the midtones. And that's all. So I hope this was easy to follow as I promised, and especially that your footage will look really, really good after these quick adjustments. Next week, instead, I will show you how to add a LUT lookup table, basically a filter for motion pictures, and also how to add a letterbox. All this without using any plugin. You just need Final Cut Pro. With these two final steps, your footage will definitely get that cinematic look you're searching for. And I will also give you my favorite LUT, which is the one I use on my Iceland video. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Please subscribe to this channel and leave me a comment. I really would like to hear from you. Thanks for watching.